I am the way, the truth, and the life. With this affirmation, Jesus established for all people the pathway of faith. These sacred words have become our pillar of light and truth through the wilderness of this world. His footprints in the sands of time are a golden trail that leads us into joy. Yes, Christ is the journey, and he is the journey's end. Come, let us walk together, and we will follow the footsteps that lead to faith and beyond.
Footsteps.
The people were waiting expectantly and wondering in their hearts if John might possibly be the Christ. John answered them all, "I baptize you with water, but one more powerful than I will come, whose sandals I am not worthy to untie." When all the people were being baptized, Jesus was baptized too. And as he was praying, heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended on him in bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, whom I love. With you I am well pleased."
From the waters of baptism, the Savior emerged saturated with the Spirit of God. Drenched with purpose, he began his ministerial sojourn. With each perfect step, a pathway of hope was being established in the hearts of the people. Steadfastly, he moved onward into undiscovered territory, teaching the pilgrims who followed him the way everlasting.
Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news about him spread throughout the whole countryside. He taught in their synagogues, and everyone praised him. The scroll of the prophet Isaiah was handed to him, and he stood up to read. Unrolling it, he found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord is on me, because he has appointed me to preach the good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to release the oppressed, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor.
The journey had begun. From town to town and village to village, Jesus went proclaiming the good news of the kingdom of God. As he went, he healed the sick and did many wonderful works. Traveling through the land, he gathered to himself many followers, from whom he chose 12 disciples. Together they began a sacred quest that would lead the world through the deserts of death and sin and into the glorious paradise of God's promised land. Everywhere he went, the people were amazed at his miracles and astonished at his teaching, for he spoke with great power.
Thank you.
said Jesus to his disciples, "If anyone would come after me, he must deny himself, take up the cross, and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it, and whoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it."
Many followers began their journey with Jesus. Their first steps were confident and bold. But as the path narrowed, it soon became evident that many parts of the road were filled with rocks and rough places. A number left the way and abandoned the journey of faith. To those who remained, Jesus gave a vision of a road paved with tears. There were crosses waiting for all who would follow him to the end. Yet through it all, they would never walk alone.
Comes in the name of the Lord.
As the road approached the great holy city, Jesus was met by a vast parade of people, shouting and praising God. The triumphant arrival of the promised king excited the whole city. As one great procession, they moved toward the temple, and for a moment, it appeared that Christ's final destination would be the palace of an earthly kingdom. Unwavering, the Savior walked past the marble halls to his divine destiny. Soon, the road would begin its twisted trek into a valley deep with shadows.
You should do as I have done for you.
In the flickering candlelight of an upper room, the journey-weary pilgrims at last rested. Taking on the role of servant, the Creator knelt before his creation. With the tears of grace, he gently washed the disciples' feet. The dust of the journey fell away, and refreshed by cleansing waters and the Savior's healing touch, the disciples were ready to rest at the table of grace. The sting of death and the deep sadness of a paradise lost. as he struggled with his father's will, did he have a glimpse of the lonesome road that was stretching out before him, a solitary way that led to a rugged tree, and another garden path, a desolate, jagged road that ended abruptly at the darkened entrance of a stone, cold tomb.
Thank you.
Journey's end. Amen.